Similar to your apiary algorithm, this partitioning approach is again is a level-wise algorithm, otherwise which is called as the improvisation of your apiary algorithm. So the limitation with respect to your apiary algorithm is it takes more number of passes to generate a candidate set. Each and every time it generates the candidate set, it has to scan the original transaction database. So when your original transaction database is very smaller in size, storing it in your memory and fetching the data from the memory, it will not be a time consuming task. Whereas on the other hand, when your transaction database for all your real world scenario, it is very larger in size and it has more number of transactions. So in that case or in that scenario, accommodating the entire large transaction database into memory, it is a time consuming task, because often memory fetches loads the performance of your system. This is one limitation. And as far as this a priori algorithm is concerned, it each and every time it generates the candidate set. So whenever it generates the candidate set, it fetches or it scans the database to find your frequent item or to eliminate your infrequent item. So this is the limitation of this a priori algorithm. So in partitioning approach, the same a priori algorithm concept is being accommodated or it is being used, but with a different modification, with a slighter modification. So in partition approach, the entire database is divided into equal n partitions. So it need not be equal, or it can be divided into n partition. Suppose if I have 15 records, which we have discussed earlier for the transaction data set. So we can divide the database into three partitions. First 5 record in one partition, second 5 record in another partition, and the last 5 in the third partition. So in this algorithm partitioning approach, the dataset is divided into three partitions. And in the first partition, find out all candidate sets in all the three partitions in parallel. So automatically, when you use a parallel approach, the entire task gets completed in one instant of time, at the same instant of time. So divide the database into equal partition. In the first pass of the algorithm, generate all candidate set in all the partition. So you have something called as local support there. So you'll be counting the support over there, but no elimination is being done over there. Simply support count of all the candidate sets is being generated. In the second pass of your algorithm, count all the support count in all the three partition, and that support is called as your global support. And now here your elimination of your infrequent item set takes place, resulting in your maximum frequent item set. So this algorithm, it gets completed into two passes, whereas a priori algorithm, it takes three passes to complete your or to find out your maximum frequent item set. So that is the improvement of a priori algorithm with respect to this particular partitioning approach. You clear or not? So divide the database into n partition. Then it has two support counts. One is your local support and another one is your global support. Local support is the support with respect to each partition, and global support is the support of overall three partition. So you find out these things. Then first pass, generate all the candidate set. In the second pass, eliminate your infrequent item set with respect to your global support, and you'll be ending up with your maximum frequent item set. You clear or not? Now here for the algorithm, divide the database into three partitions. So 1, 2, 3. Partition 1 has 5 records, partition 2 6 to 10 records, partition 3 the last 3 records. So again, let us have the minimum support is 20%. The minimum support is what? 20%. So 20% of partition will be 20% of 5, and 20% of 15 it will be 3. So your local support is what? 1, and your global support is what? 3. Global minimum support. Generate all set, all possible combination of set without eliminating your infrequent item set in all the three partitions. And then in the second pass, combine all the candidate set, count the global support from all the partition, then you will be ending up with your support count, then do the elimination. You clear or not? So when you have an item set with 0, you can eliminate it. You need not generate the candidate set, because subset of any frequent item set will be what? Infrequent item set will be? Subset of any infrequent item set will be? Sorry, superset of any infrequent item set will be? Infrequent. So when you need to any item set with 0, you need not generate the combination. You just skip it off. Here, do the test. Divide the database into three partitions. Go back to your original database transaction record what you have written in the previous class. do the process.